Hey, good morning, y'all. We got some good news today.
Jesus is Lord.
Thank God
the word works,
and you are the redeemed.
Yes.
Not going to be. Already
you are.
Yes. You just have to receive it. Now, I'm redeemed from the bad stuff, but I'm also redeemed into the blessings of my Father. Blessed when I go in, blessed when I come out, blessed in the city, blessed in the field, blessed when I get up, blessed when I go to bed at night. So somebody says, well, how are you? Well, I'm blessed. Listen, I'm blessed wherever I go, whatever I do, because I've been redeemed from. Like I told you the other day, I got in trouble over in Cuba, but I've been redeemed out of that. And I'm redeemed back into this wonderful nation. I'm redeemed into a good place to live. Praise God, we are blessed.
Yes, and just to share with you the type and shadow in the Old Testament, God brought the children of Israel out of Pharaoh's bondage.
Bondage, I like that word, slavery.
Slavery, bondage. They were in slavery. Well, God has brought us out of slavery to Satan, to sin, to the curse, to the law of sin and death.
Death, sickness, disease.
All of that. God has delivered us out of Satan's grasp. Jesus soundly defeated him, totally destroyed him, according to Hebrews 2:14. And so he freed mankind. Now, you will walk in as much freedom as you will receive.
I'm ready to receive
the whole deal. I know.
it was
a complete redemption.
And if there's something I don't know to walk in, show me Jesus, and I'll grab it and go with it.
I know it. And how do we do that? Of course, with our mouth. Okay, so he brought them out from Pharaoh and delivered them with a mighty hand. But he didn't just deliver them out from him.
He wanted them to go into a land
flowing with milk and honey.
And when the spies went and looked it out, the grapes were so large it took two men to carry them on a pole. I mean, the blessings was there. And God wanted them to have that, but they refused to go in.
How do we know God wanted them to have it? Because he said so. He told them that it was his will to bring them all into the land flowing with milk and honey. He brought them out to bring them in.
Let me say this. I'm one of the two that's going in.
Yes, amen. Go in with us. I mean, take it.
You make a decision. I'm not going to be broke no more. I'm not going to be in slavery anymore. I'm not going to be sick anymore. Jesus paid the price so that I can have all of these blessings, and I'm going to receive the blessings.
Yes, amen. One of the blessings in Deuteronomy 28 is that he will make you plenteous in goods.
Come on, preach.
That means abundant supply of the best of
everything. Amen.
So just think, abundance of automobiles, abundance of houses, abundance of money, abundance of gold and silver, abundance of every good thing. In the Amplified, it says, he will give you a surplus of prosperity.
How about a coat when it's too cold to be out here preaching?
Yes.
You see, God's got you on his mind, and the Bible says, Psalm 112, that we're supposed to be on the increase. No, that's Psalm 115.
Yeah.
So when you get older, you don't downsize, you increase. Because the blessings of God work when you're 100. The blessings of God work when you're 49. I mean, the blessings of God work all the time once you find out that you are, quote, in the kingdom. Help me, Pat, that you are what?
In the kingdom.
And you are.
Yes. Okay. So the blessing of Abraham has come upon you through Jesus Christ. But you have to receive that blessing by believing it in your heart and confessing it with your mouth.
Saying it.
Saying what the word says all the time.
So how are you today?
I am blessed of God. I am the redeemed of the Lord. I am healed by the stripes of Jesus. I am extremely rich in money, cattle, silver, gold, multi-million-dollar houses, jets, on and on and on.
All I wanted was I'm blessed. But
okay.
No. You just think you got to say the whole thing. Yes. Say it.
Say it.
Blessed in everything that you do.
Yes. Just take that word. put it in your mouth and speak it out your mouth. Another one of the blessings in Deuteronomy 28 is that you will lend unto many nations
and not have
and
to
never borrow.
Ooh, come on,
we
preach.
Started saying that when we had nothing, and we would just look at each other and say, we lend unto many nations and never borrow. And we now have vehicles all over the world that we have been able to bless other ministers of God with.
And we never borrowed for one of them, and our time's gone.
And we never wrote an appeal letter. We never took up an offering for them. We just
believed
the covenant
and said what God said. And you know, I've given away over 70 cars all over the world because the word works. Hey, we got
to
go.
I have to say this. It was because we started saying it when we had nothing.
We didn't even have a car.
I know.
But we started saying it, and we're going to continue to be blessed. And until we're with you tomorrow, saints, remember all day, hey,
Jesus is Lord.
Thank God the word works.